So welcome to today's lesson, and today we'll be talking about the Bernoulli, which happens to be a discrete probability distribution. So a discrete random variable x is said to have a Bernoulli distribution with parameter p if its probability mass function, that's its PMF, is given by this, as we see here. So here, this P here stands for the probability of success and S is the outcome. Then 1 minus P here stands for the probability of failure. In some books, you see it as Q and you have 1 minus X here. And S takes binary digits. So that's either 0 or 1. The reason why it takes binary digits is because our Bernoulli has just two outcomes. It's either there is a success or there is a failure. The Bernoulli trial is an experiment with only two possible outcomes, so a success and a failure. So for instance, when a woman goes into delivery, it's either she gives birth to a boy or a girl, so there are just two outcomes. In an accident, it's either some will die or some will survive, they will be alive. And when you have a sickness, it's either you'll be cured or you'll not be cured. So you realize that all these things, they have just two outcomes, so they follow the Bernoulli trial. And the Bernoulli distribution arises when the following three conditions are satisfied. So let's go through them. So the first one is each trial of an experiment results in an outcome that may be classified as a success or a failure, as we've discussed. And the second says that the probability of a success is the same for each trial. So that means that it doesn't change. And the trials are independent, that is, the outcome of one trial has no effect on the outcome of any other trial. So when these three conditions are satisfied, then we see that our random discrete variable follows the Bernoulli distribution. So there is a theorem here, and the theorem says that suppose X has the Bernoulli distribution with parameter P, then so this here stands for the expectation of X. So this stands for the expectation of X. It's the same as our P, which is the probability of success. And know that the expectation of X is the same as the expected value or the mean. And our variance of X is the same as P times Q. When Q here is the same as 1 minus P, that's the probability of failure. So straightforward, there is a question here. And the question says that a six-sided fair die is tossed, with each element in the sample space having a probability of 1 over 6. Find the distribution, the mean, and variance if the value 5 occurs, right? So you're supposed to find the distribution, the mean, and the variance. So remember, this is the distribution here. You're supposed to find the distribution, as we can see here. Then you're supposed to find the mean. I told you the expected value or the expectation is the same as the mean, as you can see here. You're supposed to find the variance, so using this formula. So the solution. So let's solve it here. I think it'll be better when we solve it here. So in the question, it says we should find the distribution, the mean, and the variance if the value 5 occurs. So you see, with a fair die, when you have a fair die, so the sample space of it, we know we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that means that for 5 to appear, which happens to be the probability of success, to be 1 over 6. So that means that that's our probability of success. And because we want 5 to occur, so that means when 5 occurs, we have succeeded. But when there is anything other than 5, that is a failure. So our Q, which is 1 minus P, will be equal to 1 minus 1 over 6, which will be equal to 5 over 6. So that means that our distribution, P of X, will be given as, remember, we said this is given as P X, then 1 minus P 1 minus x. So in this case, our p is 1 over 6 x, and our 1 minus p is 5 over 6 1 minus x and p of x. So, or f of x is the same thing. So that means that this particular thing here becomes the distribution. The next question said we should find for the mean. If you remember, the mean is the same as the expectation of our x is given as p, where in this case our p was 1 over 6. So that means that's our mean. And the next question said we're supposed to find for our variance. So our variance of the x is given as p times q, and we know p is the same as 1 minus p. So this will give us 1 over 6 times 5 over 6, which gives us 5 over 36. So that's all what the question wants us to do. So we can see the solution here. So our p is 1 over 6. I'm giving the explanation, and it's going to be the PMF, the distribution. So we've said that already. And our expectation is this, and our variance is this. So we are done with the Bernoulli. In our next video, we'll talk about the binomial distribution. But I have some simple questions here for you that I would like you to try them on your own to make sure you understand what you've done. So these are the questions. The first question says, how many possible outcomes can there be for a Bernoulli trial? So more than one, more than two, exactly one. This should be so simple for you. We have success or failure. The second one says, in a Bernoulli trial, the probability of success is 0.3. What's the probability of failure? So simple. And the next one says that the probability of success in the Bernoulli trial is 0.3. What is the variance? And this should also be something which should be a cool job for you. So thank you very much for following. Please don't forget to like the videos, and please subscribe to the YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you very much.